Hello, everyone. I am back with another end of the year list, this one coming from Patreon supporter Lewis Smith, and it's dedicated to the supporting characters and performances that deserve even more love. So as much as, let's say, I love Richard E. Grant and Can You Ever Forgive Me as Jack Hawk, I am betting on an Oscar nomination for him, so I'm going to take this opportunity right here to highlight some non-Oscar contenders, some out there who are deserving of even more love than they've already gotten, maybe. First up on my list, I've got Letitia Wright as Shuri in Black Panther. This character just came out of nowhere for me. She's just got so much energy. She's so smart. And Letitia Wright has this undeniable chemistry with Chadwick Boseman and really anyone around her in that movie. There are a lot of supporting characters in Black Panther that I really wanted to shout out right now, particularly Winston Duke as M'Baku. But when I walked away from that movie, especially for the first time, I just thought Shuri was the coolest. She stands out, and I just have a really good feeling that she's going to be a major bright spot in the MCU in the future. Now we're moving on to my next pick, and for this one, I am going with Nicholas Hoult as Harley in The Favorite. Everybody is talking about Olivia Colman, Emma Stone, and Rachel Weisz, and as they should be, they are all fantastic, but where is the love right now for Nick Hoult? He is not front and center, but Harley's actions are key to how everything progresses for Queen and Sarah and Abigail, and Hoult plays into it all so perfectly. Similar to the leading trio in this movie, Harley has this mesmerizing mean streak, and he manages to shine even alongside all three of them. Now, though, I gotta go on to my number three, and this position is going to Brian Tyree Henry as Daniel Carty in If Beale Street Could Talk. Give Regina King all the award season love, because she really does deserve it, but Henry is also a real standout in the movie. Thanks to just one chilling and unforgettable sequence, he pops in as this big, joyful ball of love, but then when he gets to talking to Fonny and tells him about his experience in prison, it's devastating for so many reasons. One, because of how well that particular moment is worked into the screenplay overall, and two, because Henry does such a great job offering up shades of who Daniel used to be and then how the prison system changed him, and it is really just something that can break your heart. Now, for my number four pick on this list, I'm going with Alex Wolff as Peter in Hereditary. Wow, talk about commitment to a role. I've got a very tough time watching this movie, and given what his character goes through in it, I really can't even begin to imagine how challenging it could be just to be in that headspace while making the film, and it really does come across as though Wolf gave every ounce of himself to this role. Hereditary is horrific for a number of reasons, but there are so many moments in it that are further amplified because Peter seems so deeply terrified. That just worked so well for me, and I think he deserves a lot of credit for what he did in that movie. Finally now, I've got Raffi Cassidy as Celeste and also Albertine in Vox Lux. I think Natalie Portman is great in this movie, but if I had to give someone a little award season push here for that one, it'd be Raffi Cassidy. She carries a lot of it, and there are a number of very heavy scenes here. She builds the foundation for Celeste so well before handing that role over to Portman, who of course runs with it, but then Cassidy steps back in as Albertine, Celeste's daughter, and has just no problem making her her own character while also highlighting the effect of her mother's past and present on her. Job very well done there as well. That is it for my favorite non-Oscar contender supporting performances of 2018. Before I sign off, though, one quick TV shout out I do want to give to Pretzel Jack from Channel Zero Dream Door, easily one of the best new characters introduced this year. But anyways, before this launches into another list here, please do chime in and give some shoutouts of your own in the comments section below. Another big thank you goes out to Lewis from the Patreon team for requesting this video, and to all of you out there for watching it. Please do not forget to like and share it, and I will be back soon with more Best of 2018 content real soon.